to the first meeting of the Health Committee of the session. And we would first consider nominations. And I'm going to ask the Health Committee Council. She would be high enough to tell us who's on the list.
We have 16 nominations. There's a resolution to be signed by members who are here. Of those, we are appointing Celia Afala to the Medical Advisory Committee, John Jerosa Jr. to the Medical Advisory Committee, Eric Bacon to the State Camp Safety Advisory Council, Jill Brayman-Tampa to the Medical Advisory Committee. Karen Power will be reappointed as member and chair of the Medical Advisory Committee. Lisa Dyer to the State Hospital Review and Planning Council. Rachel Eldridge to the Council on Human Blood and Transfusion Services. Douglas Grant Fish to the Medical Advisory Committee. Charles Gold to the Medical Advisory Committee. Alan Grant to the State Hospital Review and Planning Council. Carl Saylor to the Medical Advisory Committee. Susan Scrimshaw to the Minority Health Council. Robert Spann to the Continuing Care of the Retirement Community Council. Anthony Pavasis to the Medical Advisory Committee. Raul Vasquez to the Medical Advisory Committee. And Zada Wagle to the Administrative Review Board for Professional Medical Conduct. Yes.
Questions, comments? Senator Madden.
In the booklet that you gave out, this, I notice there is a nomination of an individual, Anthony P. Tartaglia, to the Medical Advisory Committee. It's not listed on the heading of the agenda for the committee meeting.
We are going to do him at our next meeting next week.
I heard
bills, legislation.
The first bill is S-2969 by Senator Montgomery, an act to amend the public health law and relating to death sentences.
Questions, comments?
I was going to vote without recommendation, but I'm going to vote in favor of that. And I think in some of the rural areas, particularly in the Adirondacks, it's almost without a doctor in 100 miles.
Right.
And there are nurse practitioners that are serving medical needs of this. I think it has merit just because of some of the rural areas.
Okay. Move the bill. Second. In favor? Opposed? Bills. Moving on. I just want to mention one quick thing. We did have our round table, which I think you got Lisa on medical home, which.
No, I just want to go to the record. I did not get a record.
You what?
Sorry. Not getting a notice of
that. Well, I'm sure you did.
Yeah. We checked from both of our offices and the community office, which is the office here in the Capitol, and so we have a notice of it.
Well, I will go back and check my records because we tend to, when we send fax, to check to make sure it's been received. So I'll look back on those records. But I want to say, in addition, it was listed on the official website of committee meetings and activities.
It wasn't listed on the printed one that was sent out because we went back and checked all the printed ones. It wasn't there.
Well, Senator Hannon, I think if you know my history with the committee, I invite everybody to everything. So I apologize if there was a glitch in communication between our offices, but I want to assure you that we always invite everybody to everything they do, and we try to do the most exhaustive outreach that we can. But we'll actually, in the future, from your office, we will announce your agenda. Okay. Next
bill is Senate 3845A by Senator Duane, an act to amend the public health law to be made from office of surgery to Committee of Personal Finance.
Questions? Comments? Yes, Senator Haddon.
This bill have met the office space surgery requirement that took about a decade to put in place. And the point was made last year by dentists who are also licensed to be physicians that they were unfairly put under this aegis because the office space surgery regulations were going into effect last June and July, and they would be put into big problems unless this bill was passed. Well, the bill wasn't passed, so how did they survive? And I think we need to get that information. And second, from the Dental Association memo of support is a question that's raised in my mind. It said virtually all of these dual licensed physicians form dental practices and practice all dentistry. Virtually all. My point is, who's not? Should they be subject to the office-based surgery regulations? And I think it's something we should find out. What was appropriate when there was an imminent introduction of those regulations in the middle of 2009 is not the case now. And I think we need to find out what's going to happen.
I'm
going
to ask. The first part of your question or your comment, though, the technical, defect may have been rectified. We are trying to verify that to see whether or not it's actually been put into regulation or whether it's just an understanding. The latter part of your comment we will look into with the word virtually, did you say?
Yeah, I was reading from their own memo. It said virtually.
So we'll look into what that means. In the meantime, the bill goes from here to finance, so there's a window for us to gather that information.
I'm without recommendations.
Okay, but first we should probably move the bill.
Mm-hmm.
Second? Okay, do you have a question, Senator, or a comment?
I second the bill to you, Mr. Chair.
All right, in favor? Opposed? All right.
Without red.
Okay.
The next bill is Senate 5000 by Senator Lane. An act to amend the public health law and insurance law in relation to cost sharing, deductible co-insurance, tier 4 prescription drugs, and to amend the executive law in relation to unlawful discriminatory practice in relation to tier 4 prescription drugs.
I think we're going to hold on to this bill. We have some technical amendments we would like to consider, so we will come back to it at a later date when we have those amendments in hand, and I will share them with you. Okay, thank you.
All blind and visually impaired patients with an audio recording of speech-to-text plan.
Questions? Comments?
No, that's what I'd say. It's a great idea. But if you read the patient bill of rights that we have for hospitalizations, it doesn't fit squarely because it already has general protection for people who are visually impaired. I really wanted to get a sense of what the discharge plan would be. I couldn't find it as an absolute four square, what it's defined as. I think there needs to be something else as more of a general proposition. The hospital association says, well, this thing is something work in progress as soon as you get to the hospital, try to discharge it. So I think what you're trying to say is they need to be informed what they should do when they're outside the use of the hospital. I think you got to work on that. I just will be without recommendation.
One more to go. Second.
My second's
good. All right. I will be voting in favor. All right. Thank you. We will meet again next Wednesday at noon. Same place. Thank you all. Have a great rest of your day.